far away.
Not often you get a second bye week. What did you do last week with that situation?
Yeah, well, we got on the film a second that the game got called off, and we just started looking at UCLA, and, you know, it's disappointing because we put some time and effort into Cal, too, and, you know, it's any time that you can't play an opponent you start to prep for, but it's kind of out of our control, so we took it on to the next opponent and just kind of moved forward, that's all.
What about on Fields? What were you trying to fix on Fields beyond just game planning with that extra week off?
No, it's just the tackling, you know, we just keep addressing it, the fundamentals that go along with it, but just really the big vision of everybody thinks that they're running inside of the football and they believe that they're the only people on the field, and just supporting it from outside in and having the guys, you know, press the near hip inside out. And just the create angles that are really sharp, so when the people, I think one of the problems you have with it when you're running ahead of the football, it's the guys that are behind you that are trying to figure out what angle you're taking, and everybody stays inside out to the ball and everybody on the outside stays outside in, makes it a lot easier for things to get defined. And I think that's what you're seeing a little bit of in our bigger plays, is guys that are going ahead of the football, and then the guys that are chasing it all of a sudden have to change their angle instead of just staying inside out and outside in. So that's stuff we worked on fundamentally, and we could steal a couple days last week.
Xavion had the two picks last game. Yeah. What's kind of spurred his emergence?
I just think it's being comfortable and getting more reps. I think there's a lot of those guys that have shown out in the practice field, and you guys are always asking, are we going to see people? But he's done it in practice. It's just they're a little bit uncertain on a couple of things early on when he got in there, and I just think it's reps. But he played really loose and free, and, you know, the interception that he had was just making a play on the ball, and he did a couple other things that, you know, didn't produce, but really, like a couple of the blitzes where he just took off and just went. So it's comfort, you know, just understanding the package and just, you know, knowing what to do and how to do it. And he's going to get a ton more reps.
Was he working at nickel some today?
He was working a little bit of safety, both sides of the safety, but he gives us a little flexibility on third down. He can play multiple spots. So it's just depending on what we're going to call. You know, he's got a skill set to play some man-to-man. He's got a skill set to blitz. So he gives us a dynamic that we haven't had there since probably Talley. He's starting to remind me a little bit of him.
This group's obviously had a lot of injuries this season, your side of the ball especially.
Yeah.
Did you see a refreshed group coming back off
you know,
last
I see,
week?
Yeah, I see a little bit of a refreshed group even this week. You know, I just think there's, you know, you get into a grind and, you know, and it's, and like I said beforehand, unfortunately we didn't play. But there's, you know, it's when you push into the middle of November, that whether you're a coach or whether you're a player, it can beat you up quite a bit. So to sit back and kind of address some of the stuff that we got to get better at, but not do it with the kind of the urgency of, like, we play in like 2 days, to be able to decompress a little bit. I think that's been mentally very healthy for us. And I think a college athlete today, with kind of the stress, the demands of schoolwork and just everything that goes along being a major college football player, to have a couple of days to just decompress helps you. And I think we